Hello guys, and welcome back to today's video. In today's video, we'll be learning about how to use arrangement option inside assembly. Now you can find this particular option inside the assembly tab over here, and here next to the assemble constraint or assembly constraint option, you will find this particular option called assembly constraints, particularly known as arrangements. Now here this particular option will help you to, you know, have different configurations of your designs. Okay, so for example, here I have created a simple assembly which contain all the possible constraints which is required for this assembly to function. Now in this particular assembly, there are three hydraulics which I want to control the distance of each hydraulics by using the constraints. So what I can do is I have already created three distance constraint. One over here that is controlling this hydraulics. The second one over here which is controlling this hydraulic system, and the third one over here which is controlling this hydraulic system. So what I can do is I can just double click on this one, and I can use the values, okay, see, I can reduce the distance to change the distance of the hydraulic system, and I can increase the distance. Now what I want is, I want to have two different conditions, where I can have one condition where the hydraulic system is all closed, or this is, you know, how the default view is going to look like, and one condition where it is all stretched out. So I need to change the values for all the three hydraulic systems so that it is look like a stretched out object. Okay, so I want to create some configurations for that. Okay, and to do so, or we generally say this as arrangement here in NX, to do so, we are going to use this particular option called arrangement. Now, first of all, if I click on arrangement, I already have an option here. Okay, that is arrangement one, which is a default arrangement. Now, if I want, I can select this name and I can say rename. So here, if I click on option called rename, I can then rename this particular arrangement one to whatever arrangement name I like. For example, this will be a arrangement which will be closed. So I'm just renaming this to closed, closed. Okay, so once this is renamed as closed, now we have one arrangement called closed, and now I can create a new one, okay, by clicking on this option called new arrangement, and then I can create a new arrangement called open. So currently I have two arrangements over here. Now as of now, it has nothing to do with the assembly so far, because this arrangement has, you know, no effect on the assembly as of now. Now out of the two, the closed arrangement is as of now the active arrangement. Okay, so there is a difference between a default arrangement and active arrangement. Default arrangement means whenever you open an assembly, this arrangement is there by default, okay, activated on the assembly. And active arrangement means currently which one is active. So if I double click on open arrangement, this one will be the open arrangement. If I double click on close arrangement, this one will be the close arrangement. Now already my assembly represents the close arrangement, but I still need to confirm the values. So here in close arrangement, I have different values for my hydraulic system. So what I can do is I can activate my close arrangement. Then I can close the arrangement assembly arrangement dialog box. And then I can right click on this distance constraint. The distance constraint is the constraint which is controlling the hydraulic system. So I have three distance constraint over here: distance, distance, and distance. So this is controlling the distance between object number 13 and object number 10, object number 11 and object number 13, object number 12 and object number 13. That is the reason it is shown as numbers over here, because in my assembly, everything is numerical. Like I have not defined any name to any component. So what I can do is I can right click on distance one and choose this option called arrangement specific. Okay, so here I can choose arrangement specific, and you can see the icon changes. Okay, from a normal icon to this icon. Again, I can right click on distance number 2 and I can make it arrangement specific. I can right click on distance number 3 and I can make it arrangement specific. Now one more thing I can do, I can right click and choose edit in arrangement. So I can edit the value in the open or the in the closed state specifically. Okay, so this is arrangement specific right now. Now what I can do is, once I've done this, okay, once I've completed this step, I can then activate the open arrangement. Okay, so how to activate open arrangement? Not by simply clicking. You have to double click on the arrangement to activate it. Okay, or you can choose this particular option called use in order to use that arrangement. So I can double click the open arrangement, then I can close it. Now here you can see this distance is in open arrangement, is not yet arrangement specific. So what I can do, I can right click, again choose arrangement specific. I can do it either one by one, or I can, you know, shift and select all the three and do it once in a go. Now what I need to do is, after making it arrangement specific, I need to modify this. Okay, in place of 90, this should be 20, for example. So this is going to be 20. So this is how this particular, you know, distance is going to look in this arrangement. Okay, same way, this distance in place of 10, it's going to be 90. Okay, so this is how this is going to look in this arrangement, this distance of this hydraulic over here, the center system. And finally, the last one should be having a distance of 90. Okay, so this is the open condition, I want to say. Okay. Now if I go to arrangement and if I just go and choose close arrangement, you can see everything is collapsing back, going to the original value, and open arrangement, everything is going to this value. Now again, remember, this is very simple task to do, but only thing is you have to be very specific with how you created your assembly and you know the entire part, and you have to make your constraints arrangement specific so that it is only occurring at that instance. Okay, like in open arrangement and a close arrangement. I hope you got the point. Okay, you can create as many different arrangements you want to, okay, for a particular assembly, and then you can simply double click and choose whichever assembly arrangement. Basically, arrangement is a representation of constraint. So whichever constraint you want to be active in that arrangement, you can keep it active or you can make it close. Okay, so that is how you can work with arrangement. So I hope you understood this particular part of creating an arrangement here inside NX. It was a very short video. It was a very simple explanation of arrangement. If you want to know more about it, please let me know and in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. And one small request, most of the people who are watching this particular video, more than 70%, are not subscribed to the channel. So kindly subscribe to the channel so that I can, you know, continue making this kind of content for you. So thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead.